This patient education video talks about an ECG or an electrocardiogram. In this video, you will see what is an ECG, importance of ECG as a standard or trusted diagnostic tool in cardiology, why is it done, preparation and procedure, the new ways of ECG, the importance of ECG in intensive care. An electrocardiogram is a simple, painless diagnostic test that can be used to check your heart's rhythm and electrical activity. Sensors attached to the skin are used to detect the electrical signals produced by your heart each time it beats. These signals are recorded by a machine and are looked at by a doctor to see if they are unusual. An ECG may be requested by a heart specialist or any doctor who thinks you might have a problem with your heart. With increasing awareness over heart health nowadays, some personal devices such as smartwatches offer ECG monitoring. Ask your doctor if this is an option for you. An electrocardiogram is a painless, non-invasive way to help diagnose many common heart problems in people of all ages. Your doctor may use an electrocardiogram to determine or detect abnormal heart rhythm, if blocked or narrowed arteries in your heart are causing chest pain or heart attack, whether you have had a previous heart attack, how well certain heart disease treatments such as a pacemaker are working. Before any surgery or after an episode of unconsciousness, an ECG is advised. Also, as a baseline recording for future, for any suspected congenital valvular heart problems, an ECG is advised by your doctor. After almost a century since its origin, ECG still remains to be the most informative diagnostic tool. You may need an ECG if you have symptoms: chest pain, dizziness, lightheadedness or confusion, heart palpitations, rapid pulse, shortness of breath, weakness, fatigue or a decline in ability to exercise. If you have a family history of heart disease, your doctor may suggest an electrocardiogram as a screening test even if you have no symptoms. If your symptoms tend to come and go, they may not be captured during a standard ECG recording. In this case, your doctor may recommend remote or continuous ECG monitoring. An electrocardiogram is a safe procedure. There is no risk of electrical shock during the test because the electrodes used do not produce electricity.
ECG does not involve any radiation. There are new ways of ECG available today. They are patch ECG, Holter monitoring, and telemetry. These techniques provide extensive and dynamic results compared to the conventional ECG. ECG plays a vital role in intensive care. ECG is used for continued monitoring in intensive care units. In case of ongoing chest pain or recent chest pain, one needs to get the ECG recorded as well as interpreted within 10 minutes to avoid further complications. Sometimes, at the time of heart attack, initial ECG may be normal, so a normal ECG doesn't exclude a heart attack. So your doctor may advise for additional diagnostic tests to confirm the underlying problem.
No special preparations are necessary for a standard electrocardiogram. Tell your doctor about any medications and supplements you take. These can often affect the results of your test. An electrocardiogram can be done in a doctor's office or hospital and is often done by a nurse or technician. You may be asked to change into a hospital gown. If you have hair on the parts of your body where the electrodes will be placed, the technician may shave the hair so that the patches stick. Once you're ready, you'll be asked to lie on an examining table or bed. During an ECG, up to 12 sensors will be attached to your chest and limbs. The electrodes are sticky patches with wires that connect to a monitor. They record the electrical signals that make your heart beat. A computer records the information and displays it as waves on a monitor or on paper. You can breathe normally during the test, but you will need to lie still. Make sure you're warm and ready to lie still. Moving, talking, or shivering may distort the test results. A standard ECG takes a few minutes. You can resume your normal activities after your electrocardiogram. Your doctor may discuss your results with you the same day as your electrocardiogram or at your next appointment. If your electrocardiogram is normal, you may not need any other tests. If the results show an abnormality with your heart, you may need another ECG or other diagnostic tests such as an echocardiogram. Treatment depends on what's causing your signs and symptoms. Your doctor will review the information recorded by the ECG machine and look for any problems with your heart. Normally, heart rate can be measured by checking your pulse. An ECG may be helpful if your pulse is difficult to feel or too fast or too irregular to count accurately. An ECG can help your doctor identify an unusually fast heart rate or an unusually slow heart rate. An ECG can show heart rhythm irregularities. These conditions may occur when any part of the heart's electrical system malfunctions. In other cases, medications can trigger arrhythmias. An ECG can show evidence of a previous heart attack or one that's in progress. The patterns on the ECG may indicate which part of your heart has been damaged as well as the extent of the damage. An ECG done while you're having symptoms can help your doctor determine whether chest pain is caused by reduced blood flow to the heart muscle. An ECG can provide clues about enlargement of the chambers or walls of the heart, heart defects, and other heart problems. If your doctor finds any problems on your ECG, additional tests like stress test, echocardiogram may be ordered to see if treatment is necessary. An electrocardiogram records the electrical signals in your heart. It's a common and painless test used to quickly detect heart problems and monitor your heart's health. Echocardiograms, also called ECGs or EKGs, are often done in a doctor's office, a clinic, or a hospital room. New generation ECG like patch ECG, ECG obtained from other body sensors, can help detect heart rhythm problems, which are infrequent. For more information, contact Dr. Raghu, Director, Cardiologist, Aster Prime Hospitals, Hyderabad, India.